What's good, LOBS family? It's another day action. And my man, you guys have been telling me about this song, to break down this bars. Everybody's telling me that the song is easy on the ear, but it's got a lot of deep lines. We're going to see what this is about. We're going to break down those bars. All we want to do is we just want to be in class. We want to learn and we want to decipher every single bar. So with no further delay, Eminem, Ed Sheeran, River Run. Here we go. I pulled up the lyrics just in case.
I've been a liar, been a thief, been a lover, been a cheat. All my sins need holy water, feel it washing over me. Well, little one, I don't want to admit to something. If all it's gonna cause is pain,
okay.
Truth in my lies right now are falling like the rain. So let the river.
Before we go into that, let's so Ed Sheeran is opening up with a solid what I assume is gonna be the chorus, with a solid chorus here. And he says, you know, being a liar, being a thief, being a lover, being a cheat. So you know, when lovers and cheats, liars and thieves. And then he says, my sins need holy water, I feel it washing over me. So he's bringing in a biblical scheme to show that, you know, he needs to be cleansed of the sins. So let's see, this already sounds like it's gonna be storytelling. So here we go.
Truth in my lies right now are falling like the rain, so let the river run.
He's coming home with his neck scratch, uh-huh, to catch black sweat jackets and dress slacks mismatched.
In the background of the song, it sounds like a couple fighting there. So he says he's coming home with his neck scratched to catch flak, sweat jackets and dress slacks mismatched. So he's comparing a dress or a uniform, the way this person is dressing, to say that just like you are wearing your sweat jackets and your slacks, it's a mismatch. It's a mismatch. So this ain't working. So we know that Eminem, he is a master lyricist and he likes to tell stories about the relationships, especially toxic relationships. So we want to delve into that and see what he teaches us through this.
Truth in my lies right now are falling like the rain, so let the river run.
He's coming home with his neck scratched to catch black,
uh-huh,
sweat jackets and dress slacks mismatched. On his breast jack, he's a sex addict and she just wants to exact revenge and get back. It's a chess match. She's on his back like a jetpack.
Good.
She's kept track of all his internet chats. And guess who just happens to be moving on to the next? Actually, just
guess who's happening, happens to be moving on to the next. Just like a chess match, because you move. Okay, here we go.
Track of all his internet chats. And guess who just happens to be moving on to the next? Actually, just shit on my last chick. And she has what my ex lacks.
Okay, so. Did you guys catch that one? So he says, just shit on my last chick, and she has what my ex lacks. So, laxatives, gives you a runny tummy. And then obviously he says, actually, just shit on my last chick, and she has what my ex lacks. So, he's finding other things within this relationship or in this person that his ex never had. Basically closing that gap.
She's on his back like a jetpack. She's kept track of all his internet chat.
You see, that's also very toxic. She kept track of all his internet chats. So if you ever find your partner keeping track of all your internet chats, that is toxic. Don't do that. That is the first sign that there's no trust in the relationship.
And guess who just happens to be moving on to the next? Actually, just shit on my last chick, and she has what my ex lacks. Cause she loves danger, psychopath. And you don't fuck with no man's girl, even I know that. But she's devised some plan to stab him in the back. Knife in hand, says the relationship's hanging by a string.
This lady is planning to kill this guy, okay.
But she's devised some plan to stab him in the back. Knife in hand, says the relationship's hanging by a string.
Okay.
So she's been on the web lately, says maybe she'll be my Gwen Stacy, the Spider-Man.
Woo, okay, do you see that little body to catch it? It's a Spider-Man scheme, so. He says also that their relationship is hanging on a strand, or by a strand, which is, you know, a strand, little string or making reference to a web. And then he says, she's been on the web lately, meaning that she's been on the internet by keeping track of internet chats. But also she's been on the web, like in Spider-Man. Spider makes a web. Maybe she'll be my Gwen Stacy. So Gwen Stacy is like the opposite version of Mary Jane in Spider-Man. So a lot of people in the comic books still up until today say that Gwen Stacy is like Spider-Man's side chick. Okay, so maybe she'll be my Gwen Stacy, she'll be my side chick to Spider-Man, to spite her man, because she just wanna provoke him or make him jealous because he's got a new girlfriend or a side chick. That is very toxic to do that. You don't do that. End it and start with the other one.
So she's been on the web lately. Says maybe she'll be my Gwen Stacy. To Spider-Man. And I know she's using me to try to play him. I don't care. Hi, Suzanne, but I should...
Okay, so I know she's using me to try to play him. I don't care. So, hi, Suzanne, but I should have said bye, Suzanne. So, he knows that... He just said in the previous verse that you don't mess with another man's girl. And then he says, you know what, he knows that she's using him to only to spite her man, to get to her man, to make him more jealous. But he says, I don't care. I don't care about this. I just want to smash. I want to smash. I don't care. Okay, so he's saying, okay, hi, Suzanne, but I should have said, bye, Suzanne. So he knows that he shouldn't have let her in. All right, but now he's let her in. Now he's going to suck. She's going to suck him dry. And you know what they say about vampires? They can only come into your house once they're invited. You have to let them in. Okay, here we go.
Spider-Man. And I know she's using me to try to play him. I don't care. Hi, Suzanne. But I should have said bye, Suzanne. Oh. After the first night. But tonight I am.
I've been a liar, been a thief. After the first night. But tonight I am. So there's been a couple of nights before this.
Said bye, Suzanne, after the first night, but tonight I am.
Okay.
I've been a liar, been a thief, been a lover, been a cheat. Oh, my sins need holy water, feel it washing over me. Well, little one, I don't want to admit to something. Your fool is gonna cause this pain. The truth in my life now we're falling like the rain.
Okay.
The river run, one night stand,
okay.
Turn it to night stand. It was
okay.
Called some light scram. Now we are tight and
Ooh, that's a deep line. One night stand turned into night stand. So a one night stand is something that, you know, you get up with a girl, you meet her for the first time, and you do your thing. You do your thing. It's over and done with. But he says one night stand turned into night stands, which means two night stands is next to beds. So that means they ended up in bed together and possibly living together. This is already going south.
Run one night stand, turn it to night stand. It was called some light scram. Now we hung tight and
he found out. Now she feels deserted and used as he left. So what he did at first to her too.
Okay.
Now how am I supposed to tell this girl that we're through?
Okay.
It's hard to find the words.
Okay, now that he's found out, so now that little bit of you know, when they were still doing it behind closed doors, it was still in the dark, it was fun. There's a famous saying that says, you know, from the Book of Life, that says stolen water is the sweetest. So while it was stolen water, it was sweet. It was fun getting behind closed doors with your side chick. But now he found out, so that lost its power. But now it seems like she wants more out of it. And he wants to end it now. It's a bit too late, my man. It's a bit too late.
First to her too. Now how am I supposed to tell this girl that we're through? It's hard to find the words, I'm aloof, nervous, and sued. I want this to hurt, but what you deserve is the truth. Don't take it personal, I just can't say this in person to you.
Don't take this personal, I just can't say it in person to you. What is he scared of? Just end it.
Want this to hurt, but what you deserve is the truth. Don't take it personal, I just can't say this in person to you. So I revert to the studio like hole in the wall diners.
Okay.
Don't have to be reserved in a booth. I just feel like the person who...
So now he starts working extra. He starts... Do you have an excuse to stay away from her? Okay.
Yo, like hole in the wall diners. Don't have to be reserved in a booth.
Okay.
I just feel like the person who I'm turning into. Irreversible, I prayed on you like it's church at the pew.
Woo, irreversible, I prayed on you like the church in a pew prayed on you. Also to gain advantage, to to suck out of them, you know, like the vampires, you know, to get what he wants out of them, like a leech. I prayed on you, like a church in a pew, because he also prayed at the church of the pew. This is a nice wordplay. Nush.
I just feel like that person who I'm turning into. Irreversible. I prayed on you like it's church at the pew. And now that I got you, I don't want you.
Now that I got you, I don't want you. We just said that. Okay.
Too irreversible. I prayed on you like it's church at the pew. And now that I got you, I don't want you. Took advantage of my thirst to pursue.
Took advantage of my thirst to pursue. So obviously, there was fun in the pursuit. But now that he got her, he's losing interest. He's losing interest. He's pulling out. So all this a game. You said it in the opening scheme. Chess.
Prayed on you like it's church at the pew. And now that I got you, I don't want you. Took advantage of my thirst to pursue. Why do I do this dirt that I do? Get on my soapbox and preach my sermon. And speech detergent and bleach is burning the wound. Cause now with her in the womb, we can't bring her in this world to the new. To use protection for I pit it to your forbidden.
Again. A biblical scheme coming through, and he says we can't bring her into this world. Should have knew to use protection before I bit into your forbidden fruit. So obviously it's unprotected sex, and that led to a baby being conceived out of an uneven yoke. It's an uneven yoke. It shouldn't have been a relationship, but now there's some stake.
In the womb, we can't bring her in this world to the new. To use protection for I'm pitted to your forbidden fruit.
I've been fuck. A liar, been a thief, been a lover, been a cheat. Oh, my sins need holy water, feel it washing over me. Little one, I don't want to admit to something. If all it's gonna cause is pain, truth in my life. Now we're falling like the rain, so let the river run.
My name.
Denver. Who's Denver? Please comment below. Who's Denver?
We'll let the river run. Okay.
Always the bridesmaid, never the bride. Hey, what can I say? If life was a...
Always the bridesmaid, never the bride? Oh, that is a deep cut in, especially today's woman. You know, you start attending more weddings. You start attending somebody else's wedding. But you never have your own wedding. You always see other people flourish in their relationship, but you never have a relationship that flourish. And that is to do with having your yoke uneven, settling with a guy that has a bad past, or that has that's still tied in a relationship, that has that baggage, but now you want to be in there. And once he has you, he just discards you. And you have this mindset of, you know, whatever the circumstance, I still want to be with this person because of the way he makes me feel. Because of the way he makes me feel. He fits in where my partner lacks. It's 80-20% rule, you know, the 80%-20% rule. So you're looking at this and, I mean, always the bridesmaid, never the bride. So yeah, you know, today's woman suffering, you know, because on TikTok everybody's the same. Now you're going there, you're gonna whip out everything, you're gonna whip out your goods, and that self-respect is lacking now. And now men are looking at you with thirst, and they want to pursue you, but they will never marry you. Again, I'm gonna say, they thirst after you, they want to pursue you, but they will never marry you. And it's because of that. Okay? Don't have your yoke uneven. You'll find your match. Don't worry.
Call me. River.
We'll let the river run.
Always the bridesmaid, never the bride. Hey, what can I say? If life was a highway, deceit was an enclave, I'd be swerving in five lanes. Speeds at a high rate, like I'm sliding on ice, mate.
Woo! It's the way it rides this beat right now. Lovely.
Bridesmaid, never the bride. Hey, what can I say? If life was a highway, deceit was an enclave, I'd be swerving in five lanes. Speed at a high rate, like I'm sliding on ice, maybe. That's what I made. If came at you sideways, I can't keep my lies straight. What I made, you terminate my baby. This love triangle left us in a rectangle.
Woo! Check out that little bar there. It says this love triangle left us in a rectangle. But he's talking about the shapes here, triangle and rectangle, but he says this love triangle, which means between him, this girl, and this other guy, left us in a rectangled. Okay, so it's also, it's in a rect, they finished, they done, there's no way back, they're now in this whole mess together. Alright, here we go.
But I made you terminate my baby.
And also he wants to abort the baby now because of this relationship being uneven. It's an uneven relationship, but it seems like she wanted in more, and now he wants to get out of this. Okay.
This love triangle left us in a rectangle. What else can I say? It was fun for a while.
Yeah.
Bet I really would have loved your smile. Uh-huh. Didn't really want to abort, but fuck it, what's one more lie to tell an unborn child?
Oh, that's deep, man. That's deep.
Been a cheat. Oh, my sins need holy water.
Feel it washing over me.
Well, little one, I don't want to admit to something. If all it's gonna cause is pain, the truth in my lies now are falling like the rain. So let the river run.
Okay, so that's Ed Sheeran. That's featuring on a track with Eminem. And it's a solid track, really. It's just teaching you about the do's and don'ts, how to have what can happen if you have your yoke uneven. But guys, that's enough of me preaching, breaking down this bars, man. If you love this reaction, please like and subscribe. Please subscribe to my channel. Let's help this channel grow. We need more eyes on this channel. We need more exposure. Let us grow this channel together. I want 1,000 subs in the next two months. The next 2 months, we need 1,000 subs on this channel. And the reason for that is obviously because we're not only doing mainstream music, we're not only doing mainstream artists, we're also doing some local music for South Africans, and we want to give them the platform and see if we can get their voices to be heard internationally. So have an awesome evening. Here we go.